God's tube doesn't leave me dry. nailed to this tree. Where are my accusers? Those who read I killed, those who have learned. In him, in the garden of indecision, there is no apprehension. In the garden of indecision, there is no apprehension. Trust in him.
I will live.
sky like cigarette burns on a bed sheet. Now my horn I step down with a shout. Up in the sun I'm gonna burn out. I should feel like dying. Dying, yeah. Till my hand, till my hand on the world, I'll be with you, you. Till my hand, till my hand on the world, I'll be with you. Obsessive to find us.
Diga não às drogas.
If you find Jesus,
se você encontrar a Jesus,
you won't be tempted by drugs.
Você não mais será tentado pelas drogas.
If you find Jesus,
se você conhecer Jesus,
he will deliver you.
Ele vai te libertar
from the grip of drugs.
Das garras da droga. We'll be right back.
in my veins. A broken window pane. Jars are locked in two place. Angled cup thrown in my face. I live in a house of clay. Dream. Somebody else is asleep. It's only when I'm left alone that I've heard what I've sown. Blood and skin beneath my nails reflect the emptiness of hell.
Say, I've heard this over and over again, but he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He never changes.
If I were a ship on the ocean, would you sow me a sail? If I were locked away in prison, would you pay my bill? If I were thirsty in the desert, would you give me a drink? Naked on a scorching street, would you walk right over me? I love you! I love you. I love you. I love you. If I had no place to sleep, would you give me a bed? If I were a stranger in a strange land, would you leave me for dead? If I would kneel to a cross, would you scream to yourself? If I became the curse, would you remove the nails? I love you. Led me away into
the promised land. Well, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. Hey, amazing grace, how sweet a sound that saved.
I used to sing everything the old way, and the Lord said, yeah, I'm going to give you, you know, it's like going from driving a Volkswagen to driving something with that big block motor in it. Once he puts that thing down deep inside of that Volkswagen, you want to run that thing as hard as you can all the time. Anybody that's ever had a fast car, you never want to just putter along. You want to get on down the road. You want to show everybody what's in that thing. So it's the same way with me when the Lord dropped this big block down in me. It's got to come out. If you don't run them hard, they won't last. You gotta run it hard.
Right. With Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want. With Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want. With Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. Well, if you want the victory, tell him what you want. You got to, if you want the victory, tell him what you want. I'm gonna hit you on the victory, tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. Well, call him up, tell him what you want. Call him up, tell him what you want. You got to call him up, tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. Well, if you want healing, tell him what you want. If you want the healing, tell him what you want. If you want the healing, tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. Well, call him up, tell him what you want. You got to call him up, tell him what you want. Come on now, call him up, tell him what you want. You want. If you want the Holy Ghost, tell him what you want. If you want the Holy Ghost, tell him what you want. Jesus on that, he's on that main line now. Well, the line is never busy. The line is never busy. And don't only call him when you need an emergency. Because I'm telling you, if you stay on that line, there'll be no emergencies that arise. Because he's in control. Call him up. Call him up, tell him what you want. I'm gonna call him up, tell him what you want. Come on now, call him up, tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. Yeah, 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 yeah. Jesus, Jesus. Jesus on the main line.
decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back.
I just want to share something with you before everybody runs off.
Great!
Just through the foolishness of preaching that people are saved, not through the idiocy of music.
Preach! Preach!
Anybody bring your Bibles?
Yeah, I got a car.
Okay. Okay. New Testament's good enough today. I'm going to read you something here. I've just got a few minutes, but I want to share with you. This is in Matthew chapter 11. Verse 28. This is Jesus talking, and he said, "Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." This is what's going on in the world today. People are walking around still with a yoke of bondage upon their back. People are walking around today in misery and suffering in their spirit. Some people are suffering in the flesh because they have the yoke of bondage upon them. You take a credit card, for instance. You go out and you max the credit card out to where you can't pay for it. And they want payment. Is that correct? They want payment on that credit card. You can't pay it. You're adding a yoke of bondage upon your back because you're in debt to this world. You want to buy a car. You see something that you like but you can't afford. And then you see something over here that you can't afford. But you go ahead and buy that which you can't afford out of your vanity and out of your greed and wanting to keep up with your neighbors. And you add more yoke of bondage upon your back. And you walk around with this and you're burdened down by it. And you can't serve the Lord because you continue to add to your dilemma daily. daily. You take the young girl, she's out on her own. She has a baby. She can't afford to live on her own with this baby. She can't work at McDonald's making $5 an hour and afford to feed that child and afford an apartment and be able to afford going back and forth to work. So she either makes herself available on the street to make money, or she ends up in a club somewhere dancing to make money. By the time this girl is 30 years old, sure, her face looks like it's 60 years old because she's been burdened down by this world. You take the young guy, he thinks that maybe he's going to go to college and the college exams are too much for him, so he needs a little pick-me-up. So he takes some speed to get him through his classes, or he fails a course and he decides he's going to drink his misery away, and that thing gets a hold of him, and that thing begins to twist on him, and that thing begins to drive you back down into the dust for where your body is going to end up one day. But I'm telling you, you don't need to carry around that yoke of bondage.
Right.
Jesus said, take his yoke. Take his yoke. In the Bible, a yoke could be a thing that went around an oxen's neck, a big wooden thing, and he pulled a plow. You're not oxen. You're children of God.
Amen.
Jesus said, I carried the cross. I pulled the plow. Continue to put those things on me. Come to me the way you are, he says. Don't try to clean up your act without Jesus. Because some of you know what that's like. You try to give up something, but you don't give it to Jesus. You try to quit alcohol, and you might quit for a couple of weeks. You might quit for a month, but you don't stop hearing the voice of the alcohol begging you to come back because you haven't given it to Jesus. You're trying to do it on your own. But you give it to Jesus, and he'll make your ear deaf to the voice of iniquity. You set your mind on things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God the Father. Seek after those things that are above, not the things of this earth. This earth is going to pass away, and everything with it. Everything that you see, the trees, the clouds, the sun, the moon, it's all going to be dissolved. There is no reason to carry around a yoke of bondage and be rooted and grounded into this earth, which is going to pass away. Our home is not here. You've got to understand, we're strangers. We're passing through this place. We're on our way to the promised land. We're on our way where the fields are much greener. We're on our way. Well, there's no need of sun because Christ is the sun and he shines. There will be no more sweating in the heat. There will be no more tears. It's paradise. This life is but a vapor. You're going to be here and then you're going to be gone. Why do you want to work for this world? This world has nothing to offer. It's filth, it's iniquity, it's sin. Look at the people that live their life in sin. Look at the way they look. It's destroying them physically. It destroys them mentally. Look at all of our rock stars, from Kurt Cobain to Jimi Hendrix, and the list goes on and on and on, who live for this world. The prince of this world is Satan. You live for this world, you live for Satan. You must have a spiritual mind in order to combat these things. You've got to let Jesus in. He stands at the door and knocks, and if anybody will open that door, he'll come in and he'll have fellowship.
Amen.
He's prepared you a table. And he stands there even today saying, come unto me. Come unto me, he says. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. Get out from under the debt of this world. You owe this world nothing. Nothing. Don't live for it. Be a servant to Christ Jesus and let him lead you into the paths of righteousness. Seek first the kingdom, his will, his plan. Surrender all you have to Christ. Surrender. Give up. You can't win on your own. You're losers without Christ. You are not worthy without the blood of Jesus Christ. Get that through your head.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what you look like. But just be yourself. Stop trying to look like everybody else. It's not important.
Yeah.
I don't want to fit into the this world, into this society. I don't want to follow the trends of this world. I'm a freak without it because I believe in something I can't see. Do you understand what I'm telling you? Be yourself. What do you think you've come to see tonight? A singer in a rock band? A reed shaking in the wind? I come in truth, and I come in love, and I come in peace, and I come in the joy of the Lord. For it is my strength. I have no power without Him. This music means nothing. I'm not bound to this music. Stop living for the music. Set your sights on Christ. This music has never changed the life of anybody. It is the spirit inside the music. It is the word that was preached through the music. The music is a dead thing. Christian bands out here that refuse to preach the gospel tell you anything any different. They're of the father, the devil. You're either with Christ or you are against Him. You're either not ashamed or you are ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. I've ran the race. I've fought the good fight. I am ready to be delivered. Endure to the end and you shall be saved. Look up, because that's where Jesus is coming from. Stop looking down, because that's where you're going to be buried. That's where you're going to be buried. You don't want to be there. You want to be there. Thanks for coming out tonight. I hope the seeds were planted. Open your hearts to Christ. Don't listen to man. You know if it's the voice of God or not. Amen. Enjoy today.